First, you need to know how to multiply a number by 2. Well, multiplying a number by 2 is actually adding this number to itself. The other thing you need to know is to divide a number by 2. This, well, there's no really other way than to know how to do it just bit by bit. Well, with a little bit of practice, it's kind of easy and fast. And also, you don't have to mind all the halves that you can get, like when you divide 7 by 2, just put 3, don't care about 3.5 and 3.5, doesn't matter, just put 3. So that gets something rather simple. Now, let's see the rest of the procedure. Let's take an example with 27 multiplied by 13. What you do here is to put numbers in two columns, 27 on the left and 13 on the right. On the left column, you are going to multiply by 2. So 27 plus 27, yeah, it's the same, but the same number. 7 and 7 and 14, you get 54. Here, you divide by 2. So, what's multiplied by 2? What multiplied by 2 makes 13? Of course, it's 6.5. 6.5. But, as I said just a little while ago, you don't care. You don't mind. You just get rid of this 0.5. Nobody cares about it. Next step, you just continue. You multiply by 2, and you get 108. Here, you divide by 2. Forgot to write it down here. Okay, or I can divide it this way. You divide by 2. 6 divided by 2 makes, yeah, 3. And we continue once more. It's kind of easy. And here, you divide by 2 again. 3 divided by 2 makes 1.5, but we keep only the 1, and we don't care about all the decimals. So, we arrive at this point where we have a 1 on the right column. The 1 on the right column means stop. So you stop here. We're almost there. Now we have to go to the step number 2. Step 2 is very easy. On the right column, you just find out all the even numbers. Here there's only one. Only one even number, which is 6. What you do with this 6? You just remove it, and you remove the number that is on the left column, just at the same line. So, since 6 and 54 are on the same line, you remove both of them. There is no even number. If they would have any more, you would do that with all of them. Now, what you do is very, very simple, because we are done with everything. Just have to add up all the numbers remaining, not the 54, all the numbers remaining on the left column, which makes, well, let's think about it, something like 6 plus 8 plus 7 makes 21. 2 and 1 and 2 makes 5, and finally 2 and 1 means 3, 351. And believe it or not, 27 multiplied by 13 makes 351. I didn't use any multiplication table to make this multiplication. Okay, there's a little tip here, is to put the smaller number in the right column to finish earlier. Here we have 27 and 13. It's better to put 13 here, because since you divide, if it's a bigger number you put, it's gonna make a lot of lines. That's a little tip. You can do that with any number, and it always works. You don't need to know any multiplication table. If you wasted time in your childhood to learn them, well, too bad. No, I'm kidding. Okay, bye-bye.